All right, so we have a special invite to lecture today. Him is has a PhD from KAIST, and now he's a professor in Dongan University. So please welcome him to your conference.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am really happy to have a chance to introduce to express an exam in front of you. So I'm very glad and happy. So let me get started with the table of contents in this presentation. So firstly, I am going to start with background and then move on to express an exam. And finally, I just briefly show you the JSON, and then I will conclude this presentation. Okay, the subject of this presentation are XML and Express. So XML and Express are technology concerned with the description and structuring of data. It is so-called data modeling. So there are two types of data files, binary files and text files. Binary files is a stream of bits of 1 and zeros, and it is designed for computers to understand. Binary files can be processed quickly because computer can easily understand the content of binary files. So in addition, it is very efficient for storing and processing and exchanging. However, you have an experience which cannot read or see the contents of the binary files, because actually binary files are designed by software dependent. So if you want to read binary files, you need a special reader or a special translators. For example, if you make a document in the Microsoft Word, you can only read the document in Microsoft only. However, when you read the MS Word document in Hangul, you cannot read it. So if you want to read the MS Word document in Hangul word processor, you need a special translator. Text files are represented by a stream of characters, alphanumeric characters. So human can read text files easily. However, the computer, many applications also can read text files easily. For example, text notepad or Microsoft Word and Hangul word processor can read text files. So it is very easy to share information and storing information using text files. However, it is very difficult to add other information, such as formatting data, pictures, and tables, and mass formulas. So computer scientists needed an ideal data format mixing these two types of data files. So they have developed and also developing data formats. For example, there are W3C recommendations. Recommendation means standards in W3C. So there are SGML, HTML, and XML format. And in ISO standard, there is Express language. And in ECMA International, there is JSON. And there are also graphical notations such as ERD and UML. Today, I'm going to explain the Express language and XML language. Express is a texture schema language used for defining a data model. It is specially designed for defining ISO 10303 step. So actually, Express language is an international standard language for defining data model, but it is specialized in step community. So it is usually used for describing and defining and so on in ISO 10303. This is one of examples described by step. So the main keyword in step is entity. In Express, schema is used to group a collection of related types. Type means in data modeling, type is a kind of class and entity. So schema is like a C++ namespace or Java package. They are very similar concept. In this example, this data model defines schema example. And the schema example contains three entities: the entity scorecard, entity student, and entity problem. A schema starts with keyword schema and ends with end schema. Express also supports several simple data types, such as number, real, integer, logical, boolean, string, and binary types. They are usually used as a type for representing attributes of entities. For example, in this example, no and point are attributes of entity problem, and no is integer type, and point is real type. Entity is a basic struct used for defining a user-defined data type in Express language. It is almost the same concept of C++ classes. And in this example, point is an entity name, and it has three attributes, x, y, z. They are a type of real. An entity also has an entity also can be used for representing attribute types. In this entity, p0 and p1 is a type of entity point. The inheritance relationship among entities also can be specified using keyword supertype of and subtype of. So when you use subtype of keyword, there is also supertype of keyword. In this example, entity car is a supertype of vehicle, and vehicle is a car is a subtype of vehicle, entity vehicle. And it's also vehicle is a super type of car. And truck is a subtype of vehicle, and it's also vehicle is a super type of truck. Actually, one of keyword means a vehicle can be a super type of one of car and truck, but it is very general. So when you use a super type keyword, one of keyword is also used together with super type. Entity data type can be abstract. Abstract means an entity data type is not intended. abstract means an entity cannot be instantiated. So in C++, the abstract classes are the same concept. So when you enact an entity as an abstract class, you use abstract keywords. So in this example, vehicle is an abstract entity. So vehicle cannot be directly instantiated. So when you use a vehicle type, you should make an entity which is a subtype of vehicle. So in this example, land-based entity or water-based entity are only can be instantiated. In defining entity, the attributes are also defined inside entity. So in this example, there are five attributes: center, radius, axis, and areas and perimeters. So there is a properties expressed or evaluated by other attributes. In this example, areas is defined by radius attribute, and the perimeter attribute is defined by radius attribute. So such a kind of attributes are called derived attribute. Optional attribute is an attribute that needs not have a value. So in this example, C is an optional attribute. So when you instantiate unit vector entity, you don't need to describe the value of C attribute. Uniqueness rules specify that no two instances of the entity data type should use the same instance for the named value. It is a kind of primary key. So when you, for example, when you instantiate the student entity, there is only one value of ID attribute because it is specified by unique keyword. So actually you can understand the unique keyword as a primary key when you are modeling data. You can constrain the attributes by using where rules. So, for example, in this example, unity vector entity has three attributes called A and A, B, and C. And also, you can constrain the relationship between A, B, and C, like this. So, in this example, the length of A squared 2 plus B squared plus 6 C squared should be equal to 0. So you can constrain the relationship between attributes like this. There are also aggregation types. Aggregation data types is a kind of array, list, and vectors in C++ programming languages. So there are four types of aggregation data types: array, list, back, and set. They are very similar concepts, but there are subtle differences among them. For example, array is a fixed size ordered collection, and the list is a variable sized ordered collection. A back is an unordered variable sized collection, and the set is an unordered variable size collection, but back can have duplicated elements, but set cannot have duplicated elements. And then you can specify an aggregate data type like this, list and array. you can also define enumeration types in using express languages like this. It is a similar concept to C++ enum keyword. And there are many other capabilities of Express, but actually Express have a full length of definition and specification. So today I will just briefly introduce the concept of Express and the basic construct. So if you want study on Express language, so you can refer to the standard documentation. So this is the standard documentation regarding Express language. So the official number ISO number is 10303 and 11. So it consists of, it has about 270 pages. So you can, if you can read, then you will fully understand Express language. So until this, do you have any question? Yes?
Is the dictionary type and the tuple type, are these native or you have to define them? You know the dictionary?
The dictionary?
The data type, like an array indexed by anything, indexed by a string.
Sorry, can you explain
like
more?
Dictionary data type.
Dictionary data type?
Right. Is it base data type or do you have to define it?
Ah.
Like
you mean the dictionary data, you by dictionary data type, you mean the key pair data type,
right, right.
Okay. Actually, Express does not have a dictionary data type, so it does not have such kind of data type. So, but I think it is very difficult because if you want to define dictionary data type by using C++, you should make some algorithm for defining dictionary. But in Express, it is very difficult to describe or specify such an algorithm.
Okay, and in Express, the association relationship and the composition, are they different or are they treated the same way?
Just there is association relationship only.
Only association.
Yeah, it is very similar to C++ language. Only the association, because it can specify only the referencing.
I see.
Yeah.
And does it only work one-way association or two-way association with a lab?
Maybe only one way.
Only one way.
Yes. So like this. So you can just specify the attributes. Association like this using attribute.
But can student be used inside scorecard and scorecard be used inside?
The programmer or the data modeler can directly specify parent or two-way association using attributes.
So it's possible.
Yeah, because if I define two-way association, then inside the entity student I can make some kind of attribute to representing association, and then inside another entity I can also define the another way association inside there.
Okay, final question. About the constraints, is it only like mathematical constraints allowed, or can you describe the semantics of the constraints? Like, can you have different types of constraints or treat it as an entity?
When you describe some constraint, we can use the mathematical expression and also use the function. In Express, we can define function, the programming function, procedure.
Okay, but can you classify constraints? Like, having treating a constraint like an entity, and then this is like a safety constraint, and this is a performance constraint. Can you, like, have different types of constraints? Or it's all just one form of constraint? like describing the semantics of the constraint?
You can understand the constraint can be represented by only the synthetically
mathematical
word. We can also make a function, programming function. I can define the length of constraint using function. For example, I can define the function named length in Express language, and inside the function, I can make some program code.
Returns a boolean.
Yes.
Yes. I saw a slide that defines a point which have x, y, z. And you are in here you define a and b by separating comma using comma.
Yes.
And, is it possible to define this entity like this attribute a and b? So it has three attributes in unit vector a, b, and c.
Sorry.
So, can I define real type of data by just using comma?
Yes, it's possible.
It's possible.
Yes.
I didn't know that.
I bring this example from the standard document.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Actually, if I replace the entity keyword with the C++ class, and then rework keyword to with the C++ the double, and they are very similar. Okay. I move to the Express G diagram. So Express G is a graphical rotation for representing Express. So it is usually used for communicating between humans. So in stack communities, the people usually communicate with each other using Express G diagram. It is very similar to UML diagram. So however, every Express constructs cannot be drawn by using Express G. So sometimes we should read the schema description. Simple data types are denoted by a time name inside the rectangular box with a vertical line. And entity data types are denoted by an entity name inside the rectangular box. So in this diagram, a point is denoted by this box and named inside the point. And there is a line entity here. And this means the real simple data type. And the attribute is represented or denoted by a solid line like this, and at the end of attribute is denoted by a solid line with circle at the end of one side. So here point, we can interpret this diagram like this. Point has an attribute named y, and its type is real. And entity line has an attribute named p0, and its type is entity point. So this entity can be drawn like this. And a supertype and subtype relationship is denoted by a thick solid line like this. So in this diagram, the car is a subtype of vehicle, And truck is a subtype of vehicle. The number one here means one of keyword. Abstract entity, to denote an abstract entity, the characters ABS precedes the name, precedes the entity name. So in this example, express schema, vehicle is specified by abstract. So in this diagram, the ABS is precedes the name of vehicle entity, like this. And to denote a derived attribute, the character DER is used in front of the attribute names. So in this entity definition, area and parameter attributes are derived attributes. So DER keywords are used here. An optional attribute is denoted by a dashed line. Aggregation data types are indicated on the attribute line following the like this. So A is an attribute name, and the capital A means an array. So in this diagram, A means an attribute name and L means a list. So you just only use the first letter of the type name. Enumeration data type is represented like this. However, you cannot specify the contents of entity data type. There are several tools for drawing express diagrams. So, for example, EDM and Step Developer tools are specialized tools for drawing express diagrams. However, they are rarely used, and it is very difficult to officially buy or obtain them. So, it is easier to use Microsoft Visual or eDrawSoft tools. There is a concept of step physical file. Step physical file is a kind of instantiation of Express schema files. So when you use a data model defined by Express language, actually you should generate a step physical file. So step physical file is defined in ISO 10303-12-1. So in this example, the left side is Express schema. There are three entities inside schema example. The right hand side is a physical file of this Express schema. So in this example, the problem is instantiated like this: entity name and attribute values. And the number one is called hash numbers. Actually, it is a kind of the instance name. In C++, we can use alphanumeric numbers for representing the instance name. However, in step physical file, we can use only numbers to representing the instances of entities. And student entity is instantiated like this. Student has two attributes, ID and problems. So ID is a type of string, so it is specified like this.
And the problem is a type of array. So array can be specified like this. And in this example, scorecard. In addition, there are many CAD softwares provide a function to express a statistical file for representing CAD models. So I will show you some examples. This is a statistical file generated from CATIA V5. In this example, the product definition is an entity name. So the numbers 4, 6 means an instance name. They are called hash numbers. So, however, there is not a schema file. So, if you want to understand the contents of this file, you need a schema definition file. Do you have any question? Yes?
Is there any tool that goes directly from Express to ExpressG?
Yes, the EDM and STEP tools can generate the Express diagram from Express language.
But it's not open source, it's not available. Commercial?
Yeah, right, commercial, and it costs much money.
I see. So the UML, there is one that we can write something like a schema and then change it to UML. It's called plan to UML, but it's nice open. Anyways, okay, just one more question.
Yes.
Maybe this is more related to UML, but is there something like step physical file for UML?
UML?
Like sort of serialization of all the objects or description of all the objects?
In Express or in step?
Similar to step physical file, but for you.
Oh, sorry. Your question is that is there any there?
Is there anything similar to a step physical file for you?
For UML, I know that there is the XMLI format. Well, it is a XMLI format. I cannot exactly remember the name. I remember that there is an XMLI format for describing UML as a XML format. But
is it the schema or the object?
Schema. There is no the physical file for UML because UML only represents the schema. The next subject is XML. XML is a very familiar language for representing data structure. So, XML is an abbreviation of Extensible Markov Language. It is usually used for formatting for representing structured information such as documents, data, invoices, and so on. It is a WCC recommendation. Express and ExpressG is the ISO standard. On the other hand, XML is a W3C standard. As you know, W3C is an organization for making standards for Web, World Wide Web, the XML was originated from SGML and HTML. As you know, HTML is a language to represent a web page. XML looks like this. This XML file has the same means to the express schema as I showed in the previous pages. So the basic the most important feature of XML is that the XML is represented by using tags. There is an important terminology called welcomed XML. The general XML document is called welcomed XML. So it means it describes some kind of grammatical rules describing XML document. Firstly, welcomed XML should start with the the welcomed XML start with the XML declaration, but it is optional. And the welcomed XML contains many elements inside the document. An element is a basic structure of XML file. An element is like an entity or classes. Element should start with the start tag and the matching end tag. In this example, CD is an element, and there is also CD ending tag like this. However, the welcomed XML can have only one root element. So, in this example, there is only one root element called CD. So there should be just one element inside one XML document. However, elements can have many child elements. For example, song has elements title, length, and parody. And elements are case sensitive, so the small t and the large t have different meanings. An element can contain contents inside the element. So in this example, the element artist has some kind of a sentence. And empty elements can be represented by simply denoted like this. So in this example, an element parody is represented by just one tag. Comments is used using the keyword like this. The welcomed XML can contain attributes inside an element like this. An element CD has attributes serial and disk. However, the attributes should be simple type. So in this example, serial is just string, and disk length is just time. XML has several features. Firstly, XML is self-describing. So even if we don't have any schema document for XML, you can understand the meaning of the document. For example, you can easily understand the meaning of this example, scorecard. Because basically XML have tags. XML is also extensible. We can shape, or we can make the data in any way we wish. So we can make XML document freely. So the same content can be described in two ways or different ways like this. Basically, XML documents represent hierarchical information. So all of the information is grouped into a hierarchy like this. The most important features of XML is that there are many XML tools. Because famous IT companies such as Adobe, Google, and Microsoft support and develop the XML technologies. So they also provide tools for XML processing. So there are many open source XML tools and commercial tools. XML has many other extensions. Firstly, XML DOM, D-O-M, Document Object Model, is a standard interface for accessing XML documents. So if you want to read XML files in your programming languages, you should use XML DOM technology. As I said just before, XML is self-describing. But if you want to describe XML document more rigorously, then you can also define XML schema. So there is a technology called XML schema. So XML schema is a description of a type of XML document. So this example, the XML schema of this XML file looks like this. Using the cascading style sheet, you can also display an XML file with colors and styles. For example, this is an XML document. It is just a text file. And this is a cascading style sheet. If I read this document inside Internet Explorer, the document is displayed with colors and styles. XML Web Services are a remote procedure call technology based on XML documents. So in XML Web Services, the interface format or the data format are described by using XML format. XML technologies are used in many places or applications. For example, this PPT file is also saved in an XML format. This PPT file. And if I change the extension of this file to zip, and then you can uncompress this file. And there are many XML files inside this zip file. Actually, the PPT is saved in an XML format file, XML document. Actually, there is a standard for representing the Office file format called Open Document Format for Office Application, shortly ODF. The scalable vector graphics is an XML-based vector image format, so you can display the XML file inside the web browsers, and this is actually this file is a general usual XML file, so there are just many tags, SVG, titles, subtitles, polylines, but when you read this file inside a web browser, it shows 2D images. Yes?
When you showed it on the browser, this is JavaScript? Because you were moving the mouse and it was moving the view.
Pastry, actually we need the plugin, but nowadays the newer web browsers support the SVG format. So we don't need any plugins.
So this mouse following feature is part of SVG?
Yes, SVG. The SVG and other technologies are part of the HTML5 technology. So the Explorer 11 and Chrome support HTML5. You can also display mathematical formulas inside the HTML or XML5. It's called using HTML and MathML. So this is a MathML format, just XML5. However, you can, when you display this file inside web browser, you can see some kind of math formula like this, pi r squared. However, as I know, only the Opera or Firefox supports natively the MathML. So if you use Internet Explorer or Chrome, you need a special plugin program.
How many mathematical functions do you support?
Mathematical formulas? As I know, you can express any mathematical formula. If they are just a display format. They don't evaluate mathematical formulas, just for displaying only. Actually, XML is used for displaying or exchanging the document. However, in HTML, we cannot display mathematical formulas. However, the MathML supports it.
To describe or to use mathematical formulas in the XML file, can we use MathML?
MathML?
Like, if I want to say 2x plus y, like a constraint in XML.
Ah, they are just a display only, just for display purpose.
So it's only for MathML?
It does not have any semantics. You can imagine that when you use MS Word or Aria Hangul Word Processor, you can insert a mathematical formula inside the document. It's the same approach.
What I mean is Express supports some mathematical formula, like constraints.
Yes.
Does XML have something similar?
No. X3D is an XML format for displaying 3D computer graphics. It is an XML version of VRML. So this is a demo for X3D. I didn't install any plugins in my web browser. However, you can see 3D graphics like this. This is the X3D technology.
What is the color?
Here? I don't know. It's just a demo program. I didn't make this. So maybe surface color. I think this is the result from the computational fluid dynamics.
So the X3D schema is made in XML also?
X3D is a schema represented by XML. Actually, to understand the X3D, the special parser is needed, but HTML5 supports this technology. XML is very popular nowadays, but there are several disadvantages. So firstly, it is difficult to map the hierarchical structure of XML to types of programming languages or database. And since XML has many tags, basically XML is described by using tags. However, the tag increases the size of XML documents. And it is basically text file. It is slower than binary files. So nowadays, programmers prefer JSON to XML for exchanging or storing data. So JSON is an abbreviation of Java Simple Object Notation. It is an ECMA standard. ECMA is one of the standard organization. The syntax is very simple. Just a JSON file has only there are just value and tag pairs. So in this example, there is only values and name. So your first name and John is denoted by only using first name value and the tag name John, like this. It's very simple. However, they have the same meaning. Okay, so as a conclusion, I summarize the differences among express XML and JSON. Express is a standard of ISO, and XML is a recommendation or standard of W3C, and JSON is a standard of ECMA International. However, Express is usually used for describing product data model, and XML is usually used for describing web document, and JSON is usually used for exchanging and storing inside JavaScript language. Express is basically an object-oriented language. However, XML and JSON is have a hierarchical structure. Express specifies the schema of data models. However, XML and JSON specifies the content or instance of some schemas. So to describe schema of XML schema is needed. However, there is no schema languages for JSON. In Express, there are another standard for describing interface procedure or process called SDI. It is very similar to XML DOM technology. The expressiveness power of Express is very high. However, Express is very complex programming language. Complex language. And so that the learning time is very long. However, the expressiveness power of XML is middle or low. So the time to learn XML is very short. So you can easily use XML. JSON is simpler than XML. So it is very short to learn JSON. So you can easily study or learn JSON. And there are many tools for processing XML and JSON. There are many open source and commercial tools for XML and JSON. However, you may not obtain tools for processing Express language. There is no homework.
What causes the expressiveness in each
language? Your question is the meaning of expressiveness. Express, XML, and JSON is a type of language. So language can express some meanings. It means
how can you decide
For example, Express can constrain the meaning or the semantics of entity attributes using where clause. However, we cannot, XML and JSON does not provide such a functions. XML also cannot express or describe the hierarchical inheritance relationship and other semantics.
So the constraints is related to the expressiveness, and it is also related to the complexity.
Yes, they are related to each other.
How is XML more expressive than JSON?
Yes.
Because the example you showed is almost equivalent.
So
both have the same amount of information.
Actually, if we use XML schema, we can describe the...
Yes, because of the schema. Okay.
Yes.
So there's no schema for JSON?
Yes.
So if you want to describe the schema, how can you do it? You have to go back to XML?
Yeah, we cannot describe any schemas in JSON.
Okay. And JSON is JavaScript based. Doesn't that also make it web supported?
Actually, the ECMA International is an organization for standardizing JavaScript.
Right, but JavaScript is also supported by HTML5.
Yes.
So it's also readable by the web browser. Yeah.
JSON is just a data format, text format. So any program can read the JSON file, but the semantics, the problem is semantics. To process JSON files, you need a parser for JSON. However, there are many open source parsers and programs for JSON.
But if it's not application specific, how can anyone use it? Usually schemas are application specific.
Yes.
Okay.
So, any questions? Yes.
You mentioned, or it's written there that XML and JSON are not object-oriented, or like only hierarchical, so how is it not object-oriented? How is it not object-oriented? What makes it not object-oriented?
Because, as I know, the OOP has several features, for example, inheritance, polymorphism, and so on. But,
it's not supported.
Yeah, not supported. Any other question? No.
Java is not object-oriented.
Object-oriented. JavaScript is an object-oriented language, right? However, the JSON is not object-oriented. They are just a key value pair description.
One final question.
Yes?
In XML, is it possible to reference a root node and a leaf node, like if I have a
Originally possible. However, it is very difficult because they basically XML is a hierarchical structure. So when you use the referencing other nodes, it looks very strange.
Right, but it's syntactically possible.
Yeah, possible.
Okay. So this can be used to define two-way association.
What do you prefer to use among these three and including other languages, and then what will be the future trend?
My preference?
Your preference?
I usually use XML, but nowadays I started using JSON because the other companies or other organization needs JSON.
Future trend will be JSON.
Not future trend, the current trend.
Trend.
Yes. As I know, though, almost web programmers use JSON for storing and exchanging data between servers and the server and client. So it is very easy to use JSON inside C# and Java programming languages. Very easy. Okay, thank you. It's the end of my presentation. Thank you.